Hydrogen trucks are starting to sell in big numbers. Nikola Motors just last week beat Wall Street expectations for second quarter revenue and posted a much smaller than expected loss on Friday, signaling a pretty big uptick in deliveries for its hydrogen big rigs. This heightened momentum, growth of more than 300% year-on-year, signals a big investment from clients and corporations into decarbonization, which is resulting in OEMs like Nikola and the hydrogen fuel cell sector being one of the biggest beneficiaries. Nikola reported record revenue of $31 million with 72 hydrogen truck sales for the second quarter. Retailers, logistics customers, and transportation companies are starting to make big moves in this electrification race, and it seems like hydrogen is starting to lead the charge. At a time when Wall Street headlines are revolving around recessionary forces and record number of bankruptcies in 2024, it's important to understand exactly why electric trucks are becoming more popular. So strap in, folks, and let's discuss why electric trucks are truly the future of the transportation sector. And what better way to start things off, folks, than by first addressing the fact that hydrogen trucks specifically are very expensive. Although for Nikola as an original equipment manufacturer, revenue grew pretty significantly, their average selling price grew by only 2%, resulting in pretty significant negative margins on each truck they sell. However, on a year-over-year basis, the loss decreased compared to 2023, which signals the benefits of economies of scale. And this brings us neatly on to an important factor for why hydrogen is starting to play a big role in the transportation industry, which is the idea you need a fuel to convert renewable excess energy into fuel that can be used anywhere and at any time. And hydrogen has the best answer for that. Electricity is great for households and for passenger electric vehicles, but for heavier duty applications with longer distances and much better energy density requirements, hydrogen plays a crucial role, particularly because right now, supply for this gas is extremely high, with most of it being used in fertilizer production and petroleum processing. And there clearly is no centralization to this production, as seen by the wide amount of production units scattered across the US. And what's driving many big corporations like Walmart Canada to invest in these expensive, at least right now, trucks is a global energy crisis accelerating the demand for cleaner energy. As it turns out, folks, clean energy isn't a scam. There are true financial and economical benefits provided by electrification, which diesel or gasoline can't do. Saving the environment is one thing. What's even better is having the ability of zero vibrations, zero noise, and a much easier driving experience, along with future-proofing your business strategy to where the industry is actually headed. Governments around the world are mandating carbon emissions disclosures, and as a result, corporations can't just ignore the effects of climate change. Not only is green technology getting cheaper every year, like solar and wind, which is going to reduce the cost of capital expenditures in hydrogen and even batteries, but there's a significant amount of subsidies for the private sector, not to mention the fact that having a decarbonized business unlocks even more economic opportunity. And even just looking at the consumer side, a recent survey conducted in 2023 showed that 71% of participants would pay a price premium for a more sustainable brand. And 49% said that they have already paid a premium for products branded as sustainable within the last 12 months. This same moniker can be translated into the commercial and industrial sectors, where companies have billions and billions of dollars in cash reserves ready to deploy for either stock buybacks, share compensation, or ESG initiatives. And well, right now, some of the highest returns that they can get is through ESG, which can allow a significant amount of financial institutions to invest with them. There are many investment institutions out there that solely want to focus on climate neutral and net zero carbon emission vehicles, and that is exactly what's driving customer demand. With France banning short-haul flights and California outlawing gas-burning cars, alongside the EU cracking down on emissions from the shipping industry, regulators as well are partaking in this ESG shift by getting serious about climate change policies. And with the progress already being made with partners as well as government authorities in building infrastructure like hydrogen stations in concentrated colonies like California, companies are feeling more comfortable investing in an early stage technology. From things like the HVIP incentive vouchers in California, New York, and New Jersey, to the omnibus regulation from the California Air Resources Board, which is strengthening standards for nitrogen oxide as well as particulate matter emissions, there are a bunch of reasons to be excited about the clean energy transition, particularly for heavy-duty transport. And what's extremely important to remember here is the fact that hydrogen specifically is not going to be the primary driver of the electric future. Trucking, for example, cannot carry the entire load for a hydrogen future because there are significant slowdowns every single year in truck population changes. This is a very cyclical industry, and these trucks are typically long-term capital investments for many commercial businesses. So it's going to take time for everybody to adopt these vehicles, which means the benefit for an early adopter is higher than ever, when they can leverage and be part of the transition and convince stakeholders to invest in their technologies. The truck manufacturing marketplace is entirely about supply and demand. The annual demand for new vehicles is anywhere from 150 to 300,000 vehicles per year, and typically it can take up to 20 years or more for a new technology to completely supplant an existing one through normal market attrition. These figures alone can give early corporations who invest in electrification a head start on the infrastructure and scaling up challenges of the future. This could boost profitability, revenue, and even business growth in the future, which just so happens to be one of the big reasons this industry is starting to gain significant traction. And don't forget the fact that there is a shortage of truck drivers in the United States, and retaining them is harder than ever before. Electric and hydrogen trucks offer the best and smoothest driving experience out of all of them, without any pollutive emissions that can cause things harmful to their bodies. All these things and factors are coming together, folks, to create an exciting outlook for the future of electric transportation, especially in the trucking sector. Time will tell how hydrogen trucks will perform over the next few years, but clearly signs are showing companies are willing to pay a price premium, even though the market is still relatively small. But as usual, folks, that is just my take on the situation, so let me know your thoughts down in the comments section below. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.